Hey, what's up everybody, my name is Trophinet and welcome to Deus Ex Mankind Divided, the long-awaited sequel to Human Revolution has finally been released to, us mere mortals. I'm gonna do a complete playthrough of it, probably on the highest difficulty, and we're gonna do this stealthy of course, because Deus Ex, in my mind, is a stealth game. I played the previous one. I played the previous one a lot, actually. I platinumed it, so I did every ending. I did a few different play styles when I went through the game. And well, I really, really, really enjoyed it. And therefore, we're going to do one in the sequel, Mankind Divided. Maybe before we head into it, I want to ask you guys how you found my channel, if this is the first time you watch any of my series. Because that would really help me out. So that's it. So leave that in the comments if you want. That will be really appreciated. So let's see what the options are here. If I understand it correctly, I think there are three difficulty options. So if you do the story, Square Enix membership is a free service. Well, we'll see about that later. I'm not gonna do that. So new game. There we go. So, give me a story is the easiest one. So, you play games for their story and experience, not for their challenge or competitiveness. Enjoy the Deus Ex experience. Maybe I'm gonna tell you this as well. My playthroughs are usually pretty thorough, so I'm gonna read pretty much everything I find, so we can dig into the story. And I'm gonna also look for every secret, every nook and cranny will be turned upside down. So give me a challenge. You enjoy a good story and a good challenge. This is how the game is meant to be played. And then we have give me Deus Ex. Hardened enemies and tougher situations will make your experience quite challenging and give you a good adrenaline rush. You are one with the machine. And then we have I never asked for this. Games aren't realistic enough for you. Give me Deus Ex, but just like in real life, you only live once. If you die, you have to restart the game from the beginning. The saved game will not help you. Complete the game once to unlock this difficulty. We're not going to do that. We're going to go for Give Me Deus Ex. And hopefully we'll fare well in that one. As I understand it correctly, I think there's a cinematic at the beginning that explains what happened in the previous game. So if you haven't played Human Revolution or haven't watched any series in that, that'll bring you up to speed. So otherwise I'm gonna explain most of it, but if that isn't the case, here we go. Okay, never mind. Control scheme, we'll go with that for now, I think. Yeah, looks pretty okay. Mankind Divided Deus Ex Human Revolution recap video. There we go. You can enjoy Deus Ex Mankind Divided as a standalone experience, but you can also relive the events of Deus Ex Human Revolution, which took place 2 years prior, by watching a 12-minute recap video. Do you want to watch the recap video now? I'm gonna include this for you guys, so enjoy!
The year was 2027. Advances in biotechnology were helping people improve their physical and mental abilities to an amazing degree. Provided, of course, they had enough money. A new breed of people was emerging. Half human, half machine. And in Detroit, at least, not everyone was happy to see it. I'd just landed a job as head of security at Seraph Industries, a cutting-edge biotech firm. David Seraph himself handpicked me for the job, said he needed me to keep his people safe. My ex, Megan Reed, was one of them. Brilliant neuroscientist, Megan had found a way to make augmentations safe and affordable for everyone. All she had to do was present her research to Congress. But the night before her big meeting, my security measures failed. A team of Black Op mercenaries stormed into Seraph headquarters, massacring everyone in sight. Three of the mercs were heavily augmented walking tanks. Their mission? Take out Megan and her team. I tried to stop them, but their leader tossed me through a plate glass wall. Last thing I heard as his bullet slammed into my brain was Megan's dying scream. I should have died with her. Only I didn't. High-end military-grade enhancements saved my life. The best augmentation Seraph's money could buy. It took me half a year to get a feel for her, should have taken longer. But 6 months into my recovery, Seraph Industries was attacked again. This time, by a radical group of pro-human purists. Violent, militant, and fanatically opposed to human augmentation, they claimed to be members of Humanity Front, a non-profit organization that wanted the UN to limit biotechnology research. The thugs broke into Seraph's factory and found machinists working overtime on a top-secret military augment called the Typhoon. Seraph sent me to retrieve it. And when I did, I found one of the so-called purists next to it, wired with cerebral implants, trying to download its classified specs. Obviously, something more was going on. The Aug killed himself before I could question him. Seraph ordered me to dig deeper, so with the help of Frank Pritchard, Seraph's head of cybersecurity, I did. Turns out a second hacker had been controlling the Aug's actions from somewhere off-site. Pritchard and I tracked his signal to a secret FEMA internment camp in Detroit. The Black Op mercenaries were there. The same mercs who'd left me for dead 6 months before. Figured they'd try again when they saw me. Wasn't so easy for them this time. I took out the tank named Barrett. Even got him to give me a new lead. A penthouse apartment in China. Of course, we both knew it would be a trap in the end. Hengxia Island, China. Home to a city so crowded, they had to build a second city on top of it. Trying to find clues in Hengxia wouldn't be easy. Lucky for me, I wasn't alone. Farida Malik, Seraph Industries' ace pilot, had lived in Hengxia before. A good person to have on your side, she knew enough about the place to get me around. Malik dropped me in the lower city, close to the penthouse Barrett had told me about. Bell Tower Associates, a private security firm under contract to the Chinese government, had agents tossing the suite when I arrived. Just not for the reason I'd been expecting. Turns out the man who lived there was a criminal hacker named Van Bruggen. The same hacker who'd been remotely controlling the Aug in Seraph's factory. Van Bruggen's panicked decision to force the man to commit suicide had been a mistake. Now his mercenary partners were gunning for him, and I needed to find him before they did. Locating Van Bruggen meant playing nice with the Triads, Hengxia's organized crime lords. They had the hacker holed up inside a low-rent capsule hotel. By the time I found him, Van Bruggen had no qualms giving up the woman who hired him. Zhao Yunru, president of the Taiyang Medical Corporation. According to Van Bruggen, Zhao wanted to monopolize the augmentation industry and had hired Black Op mercenaries to destabilize her competition. Seraph Industries was at the top of her list. To prove this, I needed to get inside TYM and grab a surveillance hologram off a server. I suspected Van Bruggen was hiding something when he told me this, but nothing could have prepared me for what I saw. Megan wasn't dead. She and her four best researchers had been kidnapped, spirited away somewhere while their kidnappers made it look like they were dead. Desperate to learn more, I confronted Zhao in her penthouse. She claimed to be a pawn in a bigger plan, and hinted at a group so powerful it controlled global interests at a whim. Then she slipped into a panic room and hit the alarm, forcing me to make a very quick exit. I figured Zhao was lying, but part of her confession made sense. David Seraph had been worried about his people. So worried, he'd required all of them to have subdermal locator devices surgically implanted. The GPOs would have been broadcasting the day of the attack. Zhao sent a single call to Picus, the world's leader in global 24-hour satellite news, and turned those signals off. I needed to fly to Picus headquarters in Montreal if I wanted to learn more. Eliza Kassan, Picus Communications' first lady of news. Malik thought I was reaching when I told her Eliza was involved in this. The world's most famous news anchor, working with a mercenary hit squad. But when I confronted Kassan in her office, She freely admitted to jamming Detroit's satellites the night Megan's team had been taken. Said she's just been following her commands. I suspected she wanted to say more. But Black Op mercenaries showed up looking to shut us both down. And just like that, the Eliza I'd been talking to disappeared. The Mercs were led by an augmented killer I crossed paths with twice before. Fedorova, a woman who'd made Silence her best friend. She waited for me to track Eliza's transmission to a secret server room underneath the Pikus complex, then jumped me from behind. A deadly fight ensued. I made sure she never moved silently again. With Fedorova down, and no one left to keep Eliza quiet, she reappeared. Turns out Pikus's first lady of news wasn't a lady at all. She was a sophisticated AI program, engineered to monitor data streams and control what people believed. Eliza told me the Mercs had brought in a Humanity Front doctor named Isaiah Sandoval to remove the scientist's implanted tracking devices while Detroit's satellites were down. She also told me to speak to David Seraph if I wanted to learn more. By the time Malik and I got back to Detroit, tensions between normal and augmented citizens had reached a flashpoint. Riots were breaking out in several cities. The UN was being urged to intervene. Seraph was trying hard to convince Hugh Darrow, the inventor turned philanthropist who'd once been a leading proponent of enhancement technologies, to help stop a possible regulatory vote. Seraph had a lot riding on Darrow. Megan's discovery would have given millions of people the chance to evolve beyond their normal human abilities, and at the same time, catapulted Seraph Industries to the top of the Fortune 500. According to Seraph, Megan's kidnappers knew this, and didn't want people evolving unless they controlled how it was done. He called his enemies Illuminati, and urged me to keep searching. Determined to do so, I tracked down Sandoval via America's most outspoken augmentation opponent, Bill Taggart, Sandoval's boss and founder of Humanity Front. Sandoval admitted to operating on Megan's team when I confronted him, but said he hadn't removed their GPLs. He'd merely switched them to a different frequency. Pritchard was able to trace one of the signals to China. Malik and I immediately took off in pursuit. Unfortunately, the Illuminati were one step ahead. Ambushed. Shot out of the sky by Bell Tower associates, seconds after entering anxious airspace. Malik's piloting skills saved me. After a tense and bitter struggle, I escaped into lower Anxia. The tracking signal I was following led straight to the Triads, or more specifically, to the augmented arm of Tong Si Hung, leader of a gang of augmentation harvesters. Tong said they'd taken the arm off a corpse, which Bell Tower had left at their door, meaning at least one of Seraph's scientists was dead. Maybe not the rest of them, though. Tong pointed me to a port used for human trafficking and helped me slip aboard a Bell Tower ship. It was sailing to Rifleman Bank Station, a military base in the South China Sea. Bell Tower was holding kidnapped civilians as prisoners there, and using them to perfect the Hyron Project, a human-computer interface that left most of its test subjects dead. My search for Megan would have ended then, if not for a mysterious ally named Quinn. In exchange for my help exposing Bell Tower, he slipped me aboard a second ship headed to Singapore and an Illuminati-run biotech facility called Omega Ranch. Three of Seraph's scientists were there, forced by their captors to create a technology capable of remotely shutting down augmented abilities. Thanks to an emergency recall notice issued by the World Health Organization, millions of people all over the world already had the biochip installed. With the help of the scientists, I tracked Megan to a private section of the ranch. There, I ran into Yaron Namir, the walking tank who'd put a bullet in my brain the first time we met. He'd teamed up with Zhao and was hoping to catch me off guard. Their little ambush didn't work. I found Megan in a suite belonging to Hugh Darrow, the billionaire philanthropist who'd Seraph had called on for help. Darrow had convinced her to go along with the biochip plan, by promising to sabotage the tech. As she was explaining this, Darrow appeared in a global broadcast, telling the world that augmentations would be the death of mankind. Then he activated the biochips to prove his point. All over the world, augmented people flew into a killing frenzy. Darrow had betrayed everyone, and it was up to me to set things right. To do it, I had to reach Panchaea, a massive installation in the Arctic Ocean. As I raced through corridors built by an all-augmented workforce, I saw death and destruction firsthand. By the time I shut down Darrow's broadcast, I knew the damage he'd done. Still, humanity's future remained unclear. How would the world react to this sabotage? Would people ever regain their faith in augmentations again? What would be the Illuminati's next move? Only time will give us the answers.
And that was it. That was Human Revolution in a nutshell. So, long story short, augmentations is, we're in the not too distant future where augmentations are normal. People replace their limbs, etc.
In yet another augmented terror attack, 251 passengers aboard Sista Airlines Flight 451 were killed. When an augmented passenger broke into the plane's cockpit,
she's still in play, apparently.
Details recovered from the black box recorder.
So it seems the unrest between augmented humans and normal humans have only escalated.
Flew into a psychotic killing spree, causing the greatest loss of life in recent history.
Sometimes you just have to let go and embrace what you've become.
Not gonna go all wonky on us now, Hansa.
Jensen doesn't really have a choice now, has he?
I guarantee you'll never see it coming.
Agent Jensen.
Okay.
Am I gonna have a problem with you?
No, sir. No reason to assume you would.
Good. Because you are the only augmented operative on this team.
Oh, he is. I was about to ask that. Okay.
Listen up, all of you. We got a sandstorm barreling down
Operation
our ass.
Operation Blade Dancer.
We're going after this man, an arms dealer named Shepard. He's ex-Bell Tower, one of the Special Forces commanders who disappeared during the incident.
And he's come out of hiding.
That cannot be good. It's not. He's selling weapons and military-grade augments to terrorists.
That does not sound good indeed.
This is Aran Singh, the undercover agent who lured Shepard out of his hole. Best you see Interpol's got. But 3 years he's worked hard to get in tight with the Jinn, an Iraqi smuggling cartel that's infected the Eastern Hemisphere like a plague. Last week, our arms dealer sent a message to the Jinn, offering to sell them a shitload of black market merchandise, dirt cheap. They told Singh to handle the buy.
They're not gonna like it when Interpol disrupts their party. Is Singh's cover really that good?
It is right now. We need to keep it that way. This is where the deal is going. A half-finished high-rise hotel that's been abandoned ever since the incident.
That looks awesome.
It's not a pretty picture inside.
Let me guess. Most of the laborers were augmented with heavy-duty industrial rigs. So when the incident hit, and they all went schizo, things got gruesome real fast.
And no one, except for some homeless junkies, have been inside the place ever since.
So what's the plan, Director?
Singh's meeting Shepard on the ground floor, inside the hotel's main atrium. He sent the bulk of his Jinn crew to the penthouse levels to secure a vantage point. I want MacReady's team to take up positions overlooking the atrium and make the arrest. Jensen, you're going in solo from the roof.
My objectives?
Keep the Jinn from joining the party. As far as we can tell, only one route connects the atrium to the penthouse level, a halfway decent elevator shaft. Here. I want you
a
to
halfway decent elevator shaft.
Fine. Just cut me loose.
I hope it's pretty decent.
Do you plan on relying solely on your augments for this one? I'd recommend taking a little hardware, just to be sure.
Okay, so as I said before, I'm gonna go for non-lethal. Non-lethal. There we go.
We've got a UC in there. Might be easier to maintain his cover if he's not the only one still breathing when this is done.
Smart thinking.
Yeah, but if anything does happen to him, you'll be telling his wife. After you get out of the hospital, of course.
Okay.
What about
Raymond?
There's lots of wide spaces and high
ceilings.
They don't
like me, I get that.
But a number of tight and constrained rooms too. So it's a crapshoot, really.
So I think we're going to go with the distance weapon, the tranquilizer rifle, because the stun gun we might actually find a few earlier on.
Well, I'm not looking to play dice with anyone in there. Give me something with distance.
Your call. Less chance of being seen and compromising Sing that way.
Indeed.
One last thing, Jensen. Sing said that Jin are using some sort of portable Wi-Fi device to boost communications. He's got a better chance of maintaining cover if you disable it.
I'll keep an eye out for it. But aren't we on the clock here? You said there's a sandstorm moving in.
There is, and we got the intel on this mission at the very last minute. So we're scrambling a little. If it comes to it, your number one priority is keeping the Jin out of that atrium.
Copy that.
Well, the lip syncing isn't all that good, but
we're approaching the target building.
I think we're getting
You're
the point.
You're up first, Jensen. Let's do this.
So a covert operative gave us some information about a terrorist organization, and we need to stop them getting some extra equipment. Sounds simple enough for now. Look at that. We're gonna just jump out like a real badass. Looks like we are. Holy shit. Okay, do we need to do anything yet? Oh, do we have that? Immediately then, the Icarus Fall, because that's a really cool augment. Because we can completely upgrade Adam, of course, every part of his augmentation system. Look at that. I'm going to switch the control scheme.
Team leader, this is Jensen. I'm on the roof.
Slightly, in a second. Are you not going to talk to me? Solid copy, move into the building. The access route you need to block is at the far end of the penthouse, and keep
Roger
in mind
that.
The direct one might be the easiest one. McRadio will advise once his team is on the ground. Miller out. Don't know why the audio didn't work, but give me a second. Already found that out as well. It came through my my controller speaker apparently, but I switched that as well. So we have a tranquilizer rifle. Look at that. No, that's crouching. Okay. And okay, what happened to this guy? Search. Credit chip. Thanks for that. 43 credits. Okay, so that's how that works. Press triangle to sprint. Okay. Oh, Icarus Fall. An empty corpse. So the terrorist organization was called Jin, if I believe, without the D, as you would have with Jins, the creature, so R3 to crouch. And we need to move quickly because of the sandstorm coming in. Okay, that was easy. A bit loud, of course, but I'm gonna try and not kill anything. Not that I can. We can search that from here even. Pocket secretary. I was working on the fan system when we lost power, stuck in here, but I think that means they can't get at me. They're killing everyone. They started screaming and attacking anything that moved. Where are you? If you can, make it up to the storage area on the roof. It's caged in. You should be safe there. Might even have some medical supplies. Door code is 4801. Be safe, friend. and no name. Oh, wait, there was a name. Khalid. Ah, cancel. It was Khalid something, but...
Jensen, we're moving through... Oh, fuck!
What's wrong?
The djinn have got a few Jennies up and running. We're gonna have to hack keypads.
You should enjoy it, MacReady. They have colors and shapes. Just remember, red means bad.
Fuck you.
Okay, so they don't really get along. Maybe a bit of explanation. The incident that they were talking about was the hack into the augmentations that you saw at the end of the recap video. So Darrow activated something in the microchip that everybody got because they thought it would help. And everybody with augment started going into a killing frenzy automatically without they being able to do anything about. And apparently most of the workforce here were augmented humans, and therefore they killed everybody when the incident happened. So there's a medical box. Was that the medical box that was locked? Probably not. So inventory. I can use the touchpad apparently, so let's check that out for a second. Typhoon ammo, so that's the special aggressive augmentation that shoots balls in all directions from your body. Yeah, that sounds dirtier than it looks. Gas grenades, smoke grenades, tranquilizer rifle, ammo for it, a biocell. What's a biocell? Oh, so I can use that to up my augmentation levels again. So my energy levels for my augments. And the hypostim injector is probably for health. Yeah, that increases the health bar. Okay. Anything else that we have? Oh, those are my augmentations. I'll probably look at that if I have more praxis points. Because that's pretty much the skill points. But let's see what we have. Social enhancer. The computer-assisted social intelligence enhancer implant analyzes the behavior patterns of conversation subjects and provides psychological data to other social assistance Augs. In cooperation with the eye known retinal prosthesis, the KC implants optical psychophysiological response analyzer optical polygraph assembles a rudimentary psychological profile based on facial expressions, body language and environmental cues, providing the user with various tools and strategies to help manipulate and persuade subjects during social interactions. Because that's also part of this game, is if you haven't played the Human Revolution, you can affect a dialogue through trying to guess which approach works better, if you're more aggressive, more feeling towards the subject you're trying to convince. Infolink. The Infolink telecommunications package enables users to receive and transmit messages without the need of an additional physical device. This technology uses the natural conduction of teeth and bone to transmit sound to the inner ear. If an eye-known retinal prosthesis is also implanted, visual signals accompanying incoming transmissions can be projected directly onto the user's retina. At its most basic level, the package uses tight-band microwave signals when sending and receiving. Various add-ons can enable the user to communicate silently or to interact with line-of-sight computer terminals and similar devices. Okay. Stealth Avatar. The Stealth Avatar upgrade activates upon detection by an attacker and monitors their behavior and eye movements in order to determine whether or not they've lost sight of the user. So we're going to see what the enemy saw, what the last position is of us that the enemy saw, so that's great. LiDAR Mark Tracker, so we can track enemies. Serif Series 8 Energy Converter transforms nutrients such as fat, glucose and adrenaline into an electrical charge that is then stored in augmentation-specific power biocells. Okay. Implanted Rebreather, also great. Icarus Landing. The device has an accelerative descent sensor built in. Free fall, the unit automatically generates a fixed focus electromagnetic lensing field. The field magnifies the Earth's ambient magnetosphere and produces a reciprocal effect. Jesus Christ. Gently pushing upwards against the user. This slows the user's fall and facilitates a smooth landing. And it can also be modulated manually to channel a portion of the energy produced by the EMF generator into a localized shockwave centered on the landing surface. The shockwave generates enough concussive force to incapacitate nearby enemies, which is also great. Quicksilver Reflex Booster is essentially a supercharger for the human nervous system. works by activating the attention button in the parasympathetic nervous system. Jesus Christ, I'm not going to read all that. So this enables military personnel to execute quicker, more impressive feats of strength and dexterity. That's a way more simpler way of telling that. The Typhoon is that amazing body attack that circles all those balls around your body. The kill, I think it's kill, right? Inject a volley of liquid crystal elastomere projectiles in a targeted 360 degree arc. The projectiles can be configured either to be lethal, explosive, or a non-lethal concussive blast. Skin, so glass cloaking, invisibility. And then we have cybernetic leg prosthesis that allow me to run and jump faster and higher than normal human can. Okay, so that should allow us to head up. So hold and move forward to grab a higher ledge. Holy shit. That was actually pretty high. Okay. So there shouldn't be any civilians around here since they all died. Look at that, they all died. Hold L3 to open the inventory augmentation screen and to equip smart vision. Select it with L and press L1 to assign. And circle to remove it. So smart vision is now assigned to L1. Oh, okay, so that's how that works. And cloaking is... okay, so now I know what that all is. And that's smart vision highlights elements you can interact with. Awesome. So I think it goes back my energy. So that's empty. More credit chips. And I can grab this. Oh. Throw. Throw. Okay, never mind. I'm gonna have to punch this properly. Look at that. Hello. His hair did something funny there. Okay, so let's crouch. Because we might be getting closer to enemy contact. Is it going back, my blue bar? Oh yeah, there it goes. So it feeds back a little bit of energy at a time, so we'll probably have to go up here. Don't really see where I should put that code in, but maybe that is for later. And there we go. Over here. Then drop down again, I suppose. Oh, that was actually just below the area. Oh, there's enemies over there. How do I get over there? Or maybe we just need to go over here. Keypad disabled. Restore power to keypad. Okay, that's clear. So we need to go over there. Okay, this is it. So use the breaker. Oh, look at that. And another biocell. Oh shit. Okay, that's why we can't go up. There we go. And now we can slowly go over everything, although I do want to check out that corpse. That's not gonna work. Okay. So let's drop down. Anything behind here? No. So let's use the keypad. It's locked. Hacking network info. Okay. And how does this work? Does this work the same way as it worked before? Use L to move the node ahead. Press X to capture node. Okay, so that's the security. Capture detection 90%.
Anomaly detected.
Okay.
Trace program initiated.
So I should be able to capture the nodes where we need to go. Can we access that? So let's just capture it. Okay, there we go. I think we found a few documents as well. But open the door. Cover tutorial. Follow the green holograms to receive tutorial instructions about various game mechanics. Experiment without any consequences. You can reset or exit at any time. Learn more about moving to cover, cover swapping. Well, I'm guessing you're going to tell me what the buttons are, right? Pipe.
I'll do another sweep in the air, just to make sure.
So I'm fucking up everything already. I might have... There we go. Okay. I'm quickly going to check out what the buttons are, because that was a bit silly. So L3 is going to cover. And then I need to just push it like this. There we go. Is that the only one in the neighborhood? Yeah, it is. So let's just do that. There we go. So they are still... They're not dead, I just tranquilized them. I can move this cardboard box apparently, but... There's no enemies nearby, so... Let's just move further. I can probably... What's this? Beer! Didn't he have a gun of some sort? No, no gun. Oh, there we go. 10mm pistol. How do I reload? I'm pushing buttons, but I'm not reloading. Okay, never mind. I'll see it when it happens. So let's hack the keypad again. A hack. So that's where the start is. We need to get over there. So let's go towards the path of least resistance.
Anomaly detected. Trace program initiated.
Yes, access you have, granted. But that's... Registry has been breached. Device has been unlocked. Okay. So, open the door. Thank you.
Jensen, Mac, listen up. Doppler shows that sandstorm's moving in fast. It's big, and it's gonna hit us hard.
God, I hate the fucking desert. Confirm visual?
I can. Time is not on our side.
Copy that.
Solid copy.
Okay, so we entered this place. Is this the place that there might have been medical supplies? Because otherwise I had the key for that, but... Do we need to go anywhere? Oh, there we go. Let's punch the wall! There we go. And let's see where this leads. Just jump through. Yeah, thank you. The Icarus landing augmentation triggers automatically to prevent fall damage, which is really cool, so I don't need to... Oh shit, okay. That wasn't supposed to happen, but hey. That was awesome. Stealth tutorial. So let's enter tutorial mode really quickly and let's see what's all that about. Reach the holograms. Okay. So that's the lag silencer augmentation. Okay. Where's the next one? Ah, okay. So the ledge below us. And now we need to... Yeah, there we go. So now we're invisible. Okay, I did that. So let's go down. So I can reset this. Okay, so hold it here. Activate the leg silencer. Then open the hatch. Go down. Put yourself here. Activate glass cloaking. Go over here. There we go. To pick up an object and throw. Well, okay, exit. Don't really know what that just told me, but hey. So let's try and slow. I don't want to have my legs making too much noise. So I am wasting stuff here. So there's two guys here. Let's turn off the leg stuff.
الموضوع شكلها هتطول لازم نخلص بسرعة.
That was... ow. What the hell just happened? So you need energy to perform a takedown? What the fuck? That was silly, but hey. Hello. Goodbye. Okay, so now that we know that, let's head into the inventory screen and use something to fill that back up, because biocell, I suppose. Oh, I didn't have that biocell. Oh, damn it. I lost the biocell that I found since I didn't do that after the checkpoint, but hey. Thank you for all that. Okay. There's one guy still left. He's right over there. No, okay, thanks for the tutorial messages. They didn't teach me anything anyway, so. There's one up there.
Good. There's too much right.
Last thing we need is the comms breaking down.
If they stop talking, yeah, okay.
MacReady, how you making out?
Slower than expected. It's like someone's tooled a fucking cemetery down here.
Say again?
When the shit hit the fan in 27, the rush must have been for the stairs. There's corpses everywhere. A lot of your cousins are here too, Jensen. Want me to grab you any spare parts?
No parts. But I take mine with cream and two sugars while you're asking.
Didn't I just fucking... Okay!
This is the end.
Yes, indeed. Let's try that again. That was fucking... That zoom on the tranquilizer rifle is fucking ridiculous. Good. Okay, so we're back here, which is great.
Last thing we need is the guns breaking down.
So let's wait for them to start moving again. Let's go from cover to cover.
MacReady, how you making out?
Slower than expected.
Saw me through the other...
Say again?
When the shit hit the fan in 27, the rush must have been for the stairs. There's corpses everywhere. A lot of your cousins are here too, Jensen. Want me to grab you any spare parts?
There we go.
No parts.
Spare parts.
But I take mine with cream and two sugars while you're asking.
Let's take that. The other guy. Ooh, the other guy's over there. There he goes. And Square is reloading. Okay then. There's another one up there. Can't really reach him yet. Hi. So that should take care of that one. Yeah, all down. Let's take all the machine pistols we can find. Okay, so we have a door over here, which just opens up.
Jensen, what's your 20?
Working my way through the penthouses.
Remember to keep an eye out for the Jin's communications booster. If you can disable
Roger that.
There's four guys down. Oh, and there's one over there as well. I should be able to take that one out. And I'm wasting a lot of energy here. There's a lot of room around here.
When are we getting out of here?
This sand is everywhere.
God damn it.
Do not worry.
Yeah, first!
I'm fucking it up again. God damn it, there's a lot of guys in here. There we go. Okay, so that works. Search completion. Okay, so we have that timer as well. How long does that actually take? So that's another one down. Still searching. Why are they searching again? Because I shot that one guy. Your implanted rebreather augmentation prevents damage from gas. Okay. And does that... Oh, yeah, that's... Oh, fuck. There we go. Oh, shit. There's three guys in here. Why are they all here? No. Leave me alone. Maybe there's anything further. There's nothing here, really. How do I get rid of the searching thingy? Oh, shit! Through this wall! Wait, where the fuck are they shooting me from? I can't go through the hazard, right? Getting used to this still. die. There's another one. Oh shit, that's a grenade. Hello.
They need to pay me more for this shit. Get him.
No. Really good at that.
But it's the slim chicken.
So I can kind of use the map to my advantage. There we go. Goodbye. Okay. And my health apparently goes back, and I'm out of searching immediately now. Sounds like a plan. Thank you for all that. Okay, so we're gonna go through here now that we know the way. Thank you. Climb the ladder like a normal person and get ourselves some higher ground. There's another vent in here. Where does this lead? Okay. Thank you guys enormously for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to like it right here on YouTube, and if you haven't already, give it a thumbs up to subscribe to my channel. See you next time!